Hi, it's Nell Tharp, and I'm going to do a demonstration of making a beef tongue model. So this is a whole beef tongue here. I'm going to take my knife, and here's the area that has the taste buds, and I'm going to cut just beyond it to make two separate models. And you want a good sharp knife whenever possible. So this end of the tongue that has the tip on it, we can use to make models of labia and to practice subcuticular closures because it has this skin on this side that is useful for that. I'm not going to make that model right now, so we're just going to set that aside. For the perineal repair model, we want to look at our piece once we've cut it to see which side, this side or this side, would look more like a perineum. And I think this side would. I make the taste buds be the vaginal mucosa. So if you picture the vulva like this, this is vagina here, and then this is perineum with the rectum down here. So in order to make the model, you can either cut a single cut, such as this, to make your laceration. But I'm actually going to take out a wedge of tissue for this model. This is a new technique that I'm trialing, so no idea of how well it will work, but the goal of the change is that we have a tear that sits open instead of sits closed. And when we bring it together, we have to actually do work to bring it together. So obviously it's not really representative of how the vagina would tear because the vaginal wall is very thin here with the pelvis underneath, you know, rectovaginal fascia and pelvis, and then the muscle would be anterior where the perineum is. The other thing to sometimes you need to do, and I'm trying to decide if I need to do it for this one, I don't think I do, is sometimes this underneath section needs to be trimmed. It looks like somebody already trimmed this one so that it lays relatively flat. You can make the model have jagged edges if you like. I'm not going to do that on this model. Sometimes the beef tongues are big and you can make more than one tear on them. I am going to use this other section. And let me think for a second. I'd like to make a tear that represents a pocket. So sometimes you get, I'm going to do it this way. That knife is not going to be sharp enough. We'll go for a scalpel here. Sometimes you get a pocket that forms. Yeah, beef tongues are tough. And I want to be careful with my scalpel. There we go. Sometimes there's a pocket that forms if this is the perineum and this is the vagina, just behind the hymen. And it may have little extensions that go back into the vagina and leave little divots of hymen that have pulled away. So I'm going to make a model like that so that we can actually focus on that today when we're doing our repairs. So. And the important thing for this is that it's really can be very challenging to see what the anatomy is when you're using a model that was made from a beef tongue. So you have to have a good imagination or have somebody help you get oriented. So there, we'll make these funky little tears. I'm gonna make a funky little midline in there as well so that she may not have an intact perineum. There we go, we'll just do one little one. Okay, and that's basically how you make the model. The benefit of the beef tongue, of course, is that it has skin here, so you can do the subcuticular closure. You can close the vagina, whereas with a plain old beef roast, you don't have that. So an alternate option with the plain beef roast is to use a piece of stockinette like you use for making baby hats and put one piece over it in each direction so that you have these outer layers that you can use to stitch for the vaginal mucosa and for the perineum. All right, thank you very much, and I hope you all have a good day.